PhyNexus is a life science tool company providing innovative and integrated high-performance purification tools for proteins and plasmids. In this talk, we present a phenomenon we call the tip concentrating effect. The tip concentrating effect is a process developed by PhyNexus that allows the recovery of high concentrations of proteins in a single purification procedure. The tip concentrating effect process has been designed to outperform all other purification techniques, including spin columns, gravity columns, magnetic beads, and FPLC. Why are high concentrations of purified proteins needed? Well, we know that low concentration protein samples are not stable in solution. There may be loss of protein mass, the protein may plate out and precipitate. There may be loss of protein activity. The protein may unfold and denature. The fidelity of proteins are better retained at higher concentrations. Accurate quantification of protein mass and concentration requires higher concentration. Assays nearly always require high protein concentration. Many analysis tools, including structure analysis tools, require high protein concentration. High-performance protein purification is needed. Centrifuge concentrator membrane filters are the most common way to increase protein concentration, but this is expensive, time-consuming, and there may be substantial protein mass loss and activity loss. Interestingly, a technology that is high-performing can always be tuned to increase purity. And finally, an added benefit to high-performance protein purification is the ability to work with limited sample. This in turn means that protein samples can be grown in a 96-well format. This dramatically reduces costs and improves workflow. PhyNexus provides the power of chromatography in a pipette tip column. Pipette tip columns are used on Rainin pipettes and automated liquid handlers. These tools provide life science researchers with high-throughput parallel sample processing in drug discovery, drug screening, assays, and structure work, any process where very high concentrations of very pure product are desired and where only limited samples may be available. Even very small sample volumes can be processed, saving money and allowing highly parallel experimentation because samples can be grown in parallel in 96-well plates. Samples can be processed up to 12 at a time or up to 96 at a time for research expression analysis, drug discovery and screening, immunogenicity screening, co-IP, IP, and CHIP, target immobilization, buffer exchange, glycosylation analysis, process development, as well as biofunctional assays. The PhyTip column is a chromatographic column in a pipette tip format. The resin bed is held in place by two screens that are specifically welded in place. This design can be applied to 0.2 milliliters or 1 milliliter pipette tips and with column bed volumes as low as 5 microliters and as high as 320 microliters. Your choice of resin can be packed into the column. The pipette tip columns are compatible with Rainin pipettes and with all major robotic systems including Tecan, Agilent, Beckman, Perkin-Elmer, Caliper, Dynamic Devices, and Hamilton Robotic Systems. These next few slides will show how the PhyTip column operates. These chromatography columns process sample, wash, and elute with the liquids flowing through the column in both directions in a back and forth flow, just as pipetting is performed. Back and forth flow is not performed with traditional chromatography columns, but as we will see, this leads to a very powerful performance. This blow-up of the column shows how the column operates. In the capture step, back and forth flow is used to capture protein onto the bed of the column. The capture is an equilibrium process, and the back and forth flow process is repeated until the capture is complete. 4 cycles of back and forth flow will normally be sufficient, but as you can see, the process will also take up some contaminants. In the next step, washing is performed to remove non-specific retained materials, that is, contaminant material that should not bind to the column. The washing step is controlled to remove all materials, but leaves the target protein on the column. That is why the process is called purifying the sample. The pipette tip columns have very low dead volume frits. The column bed volumes are small. This results in highly efficient washing process, leaving very pure protein on the column. Finally, in the last step, we elute the protein to recover them in a concentrated protein. The placement of the resin at the end of the tip and the low dead volume screens result in the ability to use very small elution volumes. Controlled exact elution of the protein into small volumes results in an efficient high concentration elution of protein. Thus, the protein is recovered as an enriched protein, a protein that is concentrated. No additional concentration step is required. This is called the tip concentrating effect. To show the advantage of the effect, we first make a comparison of a protein A spin column and a 20 microliter bed protein A PhyTip column. Both columns use capture, wash, and elution steps. However, the spin column is a single pass column with larger dead volumes, and the PhyTip pipette tip column uses back and forth flow. This gel shows the results of the comparison experiment. This band shows the antibody that is to be captured. This band is the antibody that is spiked into an E. coli cell lysate to prepare the sample. 3 samples were applied to 3 pierced nav spin columns and purified. The recovered purified samples were separated on 3 lanes of the gel. No protein can be seen, indicating that either the antibody was not recovered, or perhaps the recovered antibody is very dilute compared to the original sample. Next, the sample was applied to 3 20 microliter bed PhyTip columns. The gel band shows that the removed protein concentration is much higher than the protein recovered from the spin column. The concentration of proteins recovered from pipette tip columns is also much higher than that of the starting sample. This is the tip concentrating effect. Now, what happens when you decrease the column size to 5 microliters from 20 microliters? The PhyTip column tip concentrating effect becomes stronger. The tip concentrating effect is counterintuitive. To increase the concentration of recovered protein, use a smaller column. 5 microliter bed is a very small column bed, but will give you very high sample concentrations. Most researchers will choose the largest column that they can, but with PhyTip pipette tip column technology to increase the concentration of recovered protein, researchers use a smaller column. They use the smallest column possible while recovering the amount of protein needed for downstream processing. So continuing with our experiment, we can see how the tip concentrating effect increases using a 5 microliter bed PhyTip column over a 20 microliter bed column. Here is the gel showing the experiment. As we noted before, with the 20 microliter bed column, we get very high concentrations of recovered proteins, especially compared to spin columns. Now when we go to the smaller 5 microliter bed column, we get even higher concentrations of recovered protein. The smaller bed column produces higher concentrations of protein, This is the tip concentrating effect. The concentration is much higher than the original sample concentration. The data are shown in this table. The spin columns produce larger volumes of purified protein, but the concentrations are extremely low. Protein would have to be reconcentrated to make this usable for any type of downstream processing. On the other hand, the 20 microliter bed PhyTip column produces usable higher concentrations of proteins. This is the tip concentrating effect. But the smaller 5 microliter bed PhyTip column produces even higher concentrations of protein. In the tip concentrating effect, the smallest bed volume column used produces the highest concentration of protein. These columns show the mass recovery and the percent recovery. Mass and recovery are about the same for the three types of columns, dipping slightly for the smallest bed column. The tip concentrating effect results from being able to collect the sample in a small column format even when the column is very small. This is due to using back and forth flow until the capture is complete. The elution is performed in a very controlled manner using very small elution volumes. Small elution volumes can be used for the PhyTip columns. In the case of the 5 microliter bed column, elutions can be formed in as little as 15 microliters. All of this means the tip concentrating effect increases as the column bed size is decreased. The tip concentrating effect works with any on-off type high selectivity resin. This includes ProA, ProG, IMAC, streptavidin, ion exchange, ion pairing reverse phase. This effect works with any column analyte chemistry where the isotherms are sharp. Another way of saying this, sharp isotherms indicate that under any set of buffer conditions, the sample is either absorbed to the resin or in solution. Your PhyNexus representative can explain this further if you like, but the important thing to remember is that the tip concentrating effect works with most affinity resins. Another general rule to remember is that the researcher may match the bed size to sample concentration and volume to load up the affinity resin bed as much as possible. Because of the tip concentrating effect, the researcher will discover that even a very small column bed will produce a lot of protein. Thank you for your attention.